What's up, everybody? Chase Curtis here with Swap Mode Alive. Welcome to this week's episode of Inside SML, presented by our friends at O'Neill. All right, before we get into Nashville Supercross and discuss some things that we had going on this week at SML, let's reflect a little bit on Foxborough. As we enter the closing stretch of the 2024 Monster Energy Supercross Championship, let's be honest, a majority of the focus on teams, riders, and even fans is on the Pro Motocross Series right now. Frankly, if you're not in the championship battle, you've probably switched over to doing some outdoors riding during the week and started testing for that. We've already seen Jason Anderson out here in Southern California as he is back from Club MX and doing some outdoor testing throughout the week. We've seen Honda go to Florida for about a week and spend their time out there doing their outdoor testing. And we've also heard that the Austrian groups have been both spending some time out here in Southern California and majority out over in Florida. Doing some outdoor prep as well. This specific time of the season happens every year, and frankly, it leaves us in a little bit of a weird spot in the media. We know a majority of the fan base has a hard time checking out at this time of the season, as they're often looking forward to the beginning of a new championship come Fox Raceway. As a member of the media, that typically puts me in a weird situation, as I also can't help but think about the future storylines that will be developing regarding around the outdoors. Fortunately for us, in 2024, we are experiencing and witnessing the most exciting and closest championship we have seen in recent years. Heading into this weekend's Tennessee Supercross, we are all tied up in the 450 class. Before we get to Jett, I believe we saw the best Chase Sexton and the best Cooper Webb last weekend in Foxborough. Now with Chase, I gotta preface and say that that is the best Chase Sexton we have seen in 2024. Sure, he had a little bit more raw speed last year, but he also had the mistakes. This year, he's struggled with the raw speed, but he's been quite consistent. And in fact, he's closer at the championship right now than he was at this point in the series last year. We know he spent a few weeks at the Baker's factory doing his riding and training during the week. And I would assume that's to be closer to suspension techs and just the team personnel they have there. However, it seems he's resumed his normal riding schedule in the last couple weeks, which leads me to believe they found something and he's sticking with it. Whatever the Red Bull KTM factory racing team and Chase Sexton found in the chassis and suspension department seems to be paying off, as last weekend's performance in Foxborough was the closest thing we've seen to 2023 Chase Sexton. Personally, I believe Chase Sexton would have been your winner last weekend in Foxborough had he been able to get by Ken Roczen a couple laps earlier. Now let's move on to Cooper Webb. Much like Chase Sexton, I believe his form in Foxborough was the best Cooper Webb we had seen throughout this entire 2024 season. However, I believe it's a little bit different there because I think this is the best Cooper Webb we've seen, period, on a 450. When you sit back and think about some legendary Cooper Webb rides, it never involves a big combination in rhythm or just straight up raw speed. It typically has to do with his ability to game against his competition and just find his way to the top, even on nights you don't think he would. In the past, Cooper Webb's standout rides usually have to do with mental strategy. Let's be real, he's probably the best gamer that's on the line every single weekend. From his last corner, last lap passes, to him straight up just talking to his competitors on the starting line moments before the gate drops, there's just a lot of moments out there where Cooper Webb has been able to get into his competitors' mind. Now, I think that is still true in 2024, but I also think that we are seeing a completely different Cooper Webb in the 450 class. I don't think I've ever seen a more stylish Cooper Webb on the track. As a filmer, I get excited to film certain riders just because I know how they look on the bike. Cooper Webb in recent years really hasn't been one of those guys. Yeah, he's fast and the guy hauls ass, but he's not one of the guys that just looks like he's ripping when he's on the bike. However, I believe this year he does. I know there's probably a few of you that just watched the night program, but do yourself a favor and go watch last weekend's race day live. Cooper Webb's speed in the final session of qualifying was just unreal. All right, let's get into Jett. Man, it's been a rough couple weeks for the number 18. But even when you look at his results on paper, it's hard to understand how he's lost this many points so quickly. Let's be real, Jett probably has a little bit of an upper hand on the competition still, as he's still gonna be able to go out there and do Jett things and blow our minds. It's just been a couple weeks since we've seen that. That said, would you rather be Jett with his raw speed or Cooper Webb with his confidence? Let me know in the comments down below. All right, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, it's an interesting time of the year in our sport, especially in Southern California, as the riders are starting their outdoor prep, but still riding a little bit of Supercross here and there. That said, it's actually pretty empty out in Southern California right now, as a majority of the teams have switched over to Florida to do a lot of their testing there. The Austrian group has done a couple days over there for outdoors, it sounds like. I know all the Honda boys were out there. And other than Jason Anderson, it's actually pretty empty out in the Glen Helen Thursdays and Paula Tuesdays right now. It sounds like RJ Hampshire was actually out in Southern California last week for a couple days to do some outdoor testing. Other than that, I think we're gonna have to wait a couple more weeks to see those weirdo appearances at Glen Helen on a Thursday. Fortunately, it looks like Mother Nature has decided to change her mind about the weather in Nashville this coming weekend. On Monday's Pro Taper Kickstart podcast, Anton, Don, Ari, and I discussed the early weather prediction, which was not looking too good. Our hopes for a dry Nashville were seemingly crushed Monday night when Alex got a video from the Dirtworks guys showing how soft the soil was. However, it seems like the storm that was predicted to show up Friday and Saturday is no longer there, and aside from some scattered showers on Thursday night, it seems like we'll be having a somewhat dry Nashville. I'll say somewhat because I think it's still gonna be pretty soft. As far as some other storylines heading into Nashville, unfortunately, Aaron Plessinger will miss the remainder of the Supercross season following his crash in qualifying last weekend. It sounds like it's just an elbow fracture for the Red Bull KTM Factory Racing rider, so we can look to see him at Fox Raceway for the outdoors. Longtime racer and the grumpiest man in the pits, Phil Nicoletti, broke everyone's hearts Thursday morning when he announced that he would be retiring at the end of the 2024 Supercross season. We are still awaiting some news on Evan Ferry and Enzo Lopes. Not really sure what's going on there, but stay tuned. If you guys haven't already, make sure to check out this week's SML show. We had Joe Shimoda on, and he actually opened up a little bit about some of the struggles he had just adjusting to the Honda. It sounds like he's happy where he's at now and getting everything figured out with the team. So I think it's just a little bit different for him. He's just not used to having so many options from what it sounds like. So definitely a struggle for the first couple weeks of his season, but I believe we will definitely see a better Joe Shimoda at Nashville this weekend. All right, guys, as I mentioned, we have a tied championship in the 450 class, as well as a showdown going into Nashville. So I'm really excited for racing this Saturday. I'm sure you guys are too. Make sure to drop a comment down below. Tell me who you think is gonna win the showdown, and let me know who you think is gonna leave Nashville with the red plate in the 450 class. Thank you guys for tuning in to this week's Inside SML presented by O'Neill Racing, and I will see you guys next week.